Here's Lee. Prime time, the pass to G. Here's prime time. Foul in the act of shooting. Gets the bucket anyway, so a three-point play chance for him. What improvements, Brent, do you like to see out of players going from season one to their second season in the league?
Biggest thing, Kevin, turnovers. Player comes into the league, has an opportunity to play, wants to rush things, plays too fast, doesn't have an ability to slow down and make reads. From season one to season two, and given the role and responsibility for that player, when you watch a guy whose ability to take away the mistakes, the simple mistakes he made last year, that's growth.
Because it's connected to so many other areas of his game.
Right, and he's not trying to do things that he wasn't capable of doing when he came into the league last year. He's understanding more of where it is that he's best suited in possessions and for that offense.
Good explanation. We've got Jay. Bodyguard is out there with AI. Then there's Lights Out, and it's Mr. Moves in at the center, filling out the middle. And the basket is good. Lights Out's got 13 points.
Well, the talk at halftime must have been a good one. Right now, three straight buckets to start the quarter.
Guys, they're looking for a way to score here.
Yeah, they've had a tough time taking the lid off.
Out to Lee. King's moving the ball around. Trains the three-pointer.
Of all the action happening there, Kevin, it's the assist that jumps out to me there. That's just a great look and a great setup for the bucket.
Here's the bodyguard. 10 points for him. AI. Mr. Moves passes to AI. Missed it, even after all those chances.
His shooting has been a little bit below par. You think about what this lead would look like if he was on.
Yeah, heard the whistle and then kept his focus and able to still knock it down.
The Kings shooting their fifth attempt at the line in the game. Just over 2.5 minutes gone by here in the second half. Passes to the bodyguard. Rebound by the Kings. Now here's Lee. He has five. Clock keeps going. 3 minutes into the second half now. Now the pass to prime time. Clock at four. Here's G. Yep, that one goes in there. G's got 5 points now this quarter.
A nice run here to trim the lead, but you look up and they're still down big.
Here's the bodyguard, covered by Lee. Here's the bodyguard. No good again that time. Kings have gone 5 of 7 from the field in the third quarter. Let's see if they can keep it up. Pass to Lee. Here's Lights Out. The franchise passes to prime time. Misses the three. Gone 3 of 7 on field goal attempts here in the second half. Here's the bodyguard, covered by Lee. Passes it to Mr. Moves. Here's the bodyguard. He's got 10. Here's AI. And Lee pulls it down.
Maybe a time to rest him right now. Just give him a bit of a breather. Try to help him get back on track.
That one goes in. Lee's got 7 points in the game.
That kind of looks like a predictable shot, one that they want. The defense has to prevent the ball from getting into that sweet spot.
To the middle. And it's AI missing.
Time for some consideration in the passing category, maybe, Kevin. The shot is just not on. Get somebody else going.
There's the pass to Lights Out. Lee, bounce pass. Pass to Lights Out. Three-pointer. Sinks the three-pointer. Lights Out's got his second bucket tonight.
Well, they're getting stops, and they're attacking on the offensive end.
Yeah, coaching staff probably loves this, just grinding out defensive possessions, which is helping them get back into their offensive flow.
Here's Lights Out, 13 points in the game.
Well, I love when guys still use fundamentals to box out and rebound. He cleared his man out effectively on the box and then stepped towards the ball to grab it.
And it's G finishing it off.
The adjustments they've made offensively. defensively. They're putting guys in a position now to succeed.
Yeah, possessions is way more efficient, I think, here tonight, taking smarter, better shots, moving the ball around. That's helped them to get back in the ballgame.
Here's the bodyguard after the Kings pick up two. Passes it to Mr. Moores. To end the drought, here's the bodyguard. That's all good, and that's his fifth basket of the game. He's shooting 5 for 11 now.
And Matador defense, that's one of the easiest shots he is ever going to see.
Yeah, feels like Christmas right now, just gift-wrapping points.
Timeout called by the Kings. You know, Brett, we know guys love really jawing at each other. What was your criteria for issuing a double technical for trash talk?
Yeah, in today's game, it's kind of like it could be a whisper,
right,
or a wink.
It's both sides, doesn't it?
And they just try to curtail anything that could escalate, Kevin. That's really what the referees are doing. As soon as they see some kind of body movement or see guys starting that way, they want to cut it off before anything else happens. So the criteria is a little bit confusing. Sometimes I like to see them get after it.
Here's the franchise. Connects on the open gym. The franchise has got 14.
Pretty much all of their buckets coming from inside the paint now.
Now AI. And there's the pass to the body. Off target from three-point range.
Yeah, the defense there in chill mode. We all know he can burn them from three-point range.
Lee outside. Pass to Money. Lee left side. Makes it off the glass. He's got 9.
All the way to the bucket. No resistance. Just swipe the candy from him.
Here's the bodyguard, covered by Lee. AI.
Really out of the right play defensively. If you can't block, force him to the line.
First trip to the line for him here. Good, AI. Shorty, he's checked in for the Kings. And both free throws good for AI. The Kings shooting so far, very efficient. All around, about 55%. Here's Money. He's guarded by AI. And it's good for two. 16 points for the franchise.
And they're beginning to just flat out fall apart defensively right now, especially on the interior.
The bodyguard passes to lights out. Out to AI. Fires the three. It's hauled in by the Kings. The franchise has got 9 rebounds now tonight. Here's Shorty. No points in the game yet for him. Passes it to the franchise. Out to the wing. Shot clock at 5. The 17-footer. That shot misses. Well, they're really making a point of keeping the ball moving around.
That's the key. The defense focus on one player, and no matter what anybody tells you, that ball will always move quicker than the defender.
He's checked in for the franchise. Here's the bodyguard. 12 points for him. Puts it up from 17. Here's AI. It's hauled in by the Kings. He's got his 4th rebound in this one. And a blazing start to the new season. We look at the updated power ranking. Some teams are hot and some teams aren't. They're gaining on some of the teams above them, trying hard to crack into that top 5.
Well, right now for the Kings, they're just so locked in right now. It doesn't matter who they're playing. I know it's still early in the season, but they may turn out to be a team to beat.
On offense, here are the Kings. 6-point game. Here's Shorty. He's guarded by AI. And the foul called on Mr. Moves. That'll be his 2nd foul of the game. Shorty, the pass to Money. 6 on the shot clock. There's Rosario. Drills it from outside. He's got his third basket of the night right there.
Such a critical part of how their offense is going to flow. Things are only working when he seems to be on the floor.
And now the Kings fast break. Here's Shorty. Draws contact on the shot, and now a three-point play chance as he'll head to the line.
And that's such good work to make this a one-possession game. Terrific steal to get it all started.
First trip to the free throw line for him tonight. That one drops. He ties it up. 47% from the floor, getting it done. Here's AI, blanketed by the D. He fights to the rim for the layup. AI's got 8 points.
And giving up some inches inside, but makes up for it with an aggressive stop.
Yeah, the big man not going to slow him down from getting that deuce.
And contact on the shot, so he'll be shooting free throws here.
Clearly a foul.
The Kings shooting their 7th and 8th free throw attempts for the game right here.
Yeah, and fairly decent a season ago, about 77% from the line.
Both shots good from the stripe.
And what an advantage. You really feel like you can always trust him when he's at the line.
Here's the bodyguard. He's got 12. And the pass to Alvarado. AI outside, pass to the body. The offensive rebound goes up again. No good on that one.
The game has been very close in a lot of areas, but rebounding has been the one differentiator thus far.
1:43 left here in the third quarter. And foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line. The Kings have missed 4 of their 8 free throws up to this point. Things not really going their way at the line yet. And they now lead as the free throw drops for him. That's also good, so he hits both free throws.
They're doing a better job of working themselves to the line here in the second half.
It has to be. Let's it go from 14. And he hits the jumper for 2. He's got 7. 1:24 left in the third quarter. Let's go now to the sideline and catch up with David Alder.
Well, Kevin, tampering is a touchy subject, but it's a word we're hearing more often. Teams want to retain their star players, but they know that there's always talk during a season. And teams can only express interest in a player when he hits free agency. Players can talk amongst each other freely all season. Star players like LeBron James are tied into their front offices. Some people wonder if there's much of a difference between what the player says and what his team is thinking. Kevin?
Good point, David. Thank you. 41 seconds left to play in the third. Pushing it up. Off on the layup.
I'm a fan of anybody who defends that way. I mean, they weren't about to open the door and just allow him to cruise in for a layup.
No good on that one. Here's Money. He's got 7. And he gets the whistle. 2 free throws coming up.
All the officials are all over that one.
This is his first free throw of the game.
Taking 2 shots.
And the second free throw, good.
And you can sense that the pressure might have gotten to him a little bit, but he did do enough to put them in the lead.
Here's B. And the last shot before the buzzer is off. 3 quarters of play and a close game here. Kings ahead. While we have the chance now, folks, let's go to... State Farm assist of the game.
Yeah, an easy choice tonight. Look at the precision on this pass. Put it on a platter for him.
Well, there's a way to break down the defense with the handle, but you could do it with the pass. Prime example of that right there.
And three quarters behind us, we start the fourth quarter in what is still anybody's ball game. We've got Jay. Z out there with Shorty. Then there's Jay, and it's V at center. And a missed layup. Shooting at 46%, making some buckets. Here's the floater. And there's the foul. It'll go on AI. That'll be his second foul of the game. The Kings shooting at 52% for the field. They're clicking. The pass to Mendoza. Pass to Jay. Gets an open look and hits. Jay's kind of got the lead up to three now for the Kings.
Can't talk enough about the subtleties in that setup right there. The assist, really the key to that entire sequence.
And we play through about a minute here in the fourth. Kicks it to AI. Passes to Mr. Moves. Another shot. Count it.
You don't want to get that. Hang on.
On offense, here are the Kings. They lead by one. About a minute and a half through the fourth quarter now. Now the pass to B. Nails the 16-footer.
Two teammates connecting right there. Slick feed.
Gone 1 of 3 from the field to start the fourth quarter. AI outside. And the call on the shot that sends him to the line. That free throw, no good. Hits the second from the line.
And not a single free throw attempt in that first half, but he has been far more active since the break and drawing some fouls.
Here's Shorty. Pass to B. Pass to Mendoza. 5 on the clock. From deep. And he's good on the three ball. D's got himself on the board with 3 there.
The defenders need to recognize the importance of staying on him as we get into crunch time.
Out that one, and the Kings' lead has been cut back down to 2 points on the basket from B. Timeout called by the Kings.
Well, they've been turning that ball over way too much, and they really need to address this if they want to win this game. Huddle up, boys.
Said to his team, he told him, hey, this game is there for you, but we got to go get it. 50-50 balls, getting to the basket. We have to give it all right now. Kevin?
Thanks so much, David. Offline from the top of the key.
And I was sure that was money on that one, but everyone is afforded an easy miss or two.
Yeah, that happens. Important thing is for players, just don't beat yourself up and make a miss like that cost you another play.
Now, here's AI. And there's the pass to the Eraser. The shot goes down, and he gets this game back to even. The Eraser's got his first points of the night. The Kings have gone 3 of 5 here in the fourth quarter. Pretty good numbers coming out of the break. Here's Primetime. He's guarded by AI. Primetime. And that one clearly a foul. Gets the whistle, and 2 shots coming up.
Well, I'll tell you what, he earned his money on that foul.
In for Jay. Both good from the line that time. The visitors with the ball. That'll be the first of two straight at home. And we're about 3.5 minutes into the fourth quarter. Here's Webb. Tips it up. The key shooting has been terrific. 54% on the game. Pass to lights out. From the top of the key, bullseye. And the Kings lead by four.
Just a little bit off in the first, but he's been anything but that here in the second quarter. Really impressive to see him turn it around like that.
2 points, that one goes.
And how about the grit and determination in the post? I mean, essential qualities to have late in a close game.
To the paint. Here's Jay. An easy 2 points on the layup.
An even stronger second half. Tremendous efficiency at the offensive end of the floor.
Gone 4 of 8 in this fourth quarter, shooting an even 50% from the field. AI outside. Knocked away. Pass to Big Dog. 4 on the clock. Here's AI. It's hauled in by the Kings. D passes to primetime. Count that bucket. Now it's a 6-point Kings lead. Being here about 46% for the game. And we have an intentional foul there, GA. Wish I could say why.
Pretty strange. I mean, no idea what got into his head right there.
Lights out, checked in for Jay. Here's the feed to AI. To the inside. Webb against Lee. Webb can't hit. Kings leading now by 6. Some firepower from this offense tonight.
Yeah, they got a nice groove going right now offensively.
That's a 2 from Lee. Misses the chippy right there. 40% in the fourth. Here's AI. And the bucket is good. 3-point play chance here for him.
He was sitting back a little bit there in the first half, but feels like showtime now, and he's ready to put some major points up on the board.
Bodyguards checked in for Webb. He throw good. AI. Kings have gone 6 of 9 on their field goal attempt since the start of the fourth quarter. Out to the right wing. Here's G. The pass to the franchise. He feeds it to G. Buries it down low. G's got 9 points here in the second half.
Well, that's a defensive breakdown. You can't let him get that deep.
Yeah, how do you let him get a lounge chair down there and be comfortable in the paint like that?
And up the court come the Kings on the break. Count that one. Primetime's got the lead up to 7 now for the Kings.
Assists like that have typified their effort today. Terrific ball movement.
Here's the bodyguard covered by Lee. Comes up empty from 19 feet out.
And that's the battle they haven't been winning today. Their work on the glass has been porous, and that's got to change.
Down low. Here's the franchise. It drops. That's his 9th field goal of the contest. A blistering hot 9 for 11.
Yeah, they're going to have a nice cool run here.
Look at the franchise. What a contribution.
And they simply have no answer right now for what he's doing to them. He is making them pay.
Now the presentation of our Jordan player of the game, the franchise.
Yeah, and his percentage from the field tonight seemed almost made up. I didn't think it was possible to have that kind of success shooting the basketball. You need a little bit of luck, a bunch of hard work, and a whole lot of talent.
The better he played, the more these fans got revved up. And that continued to play out over the course of his amazing performance. Here's the bodyguard. The Kings getting the bucket. Inside, here's the eraser, and it's blocked. Right side, Lee, pass to primetime. Since they've converted,
and they've got to find a way to change that.
The pass to the body. Money from the wing.
Clearly defensive miscue there. If there's not a body on him that's sitting at the mid-range, that's a defensive mistake.
Now here's Lee. Pass to Primetime to the wing on the left. Here's the franchise. He makes his 10th basket of the night from the field. He has missed two shots from the floor.
Sweet to be a difference maker in the game, and he's been a great option for them on these possessions.
To the middle. Out that one, and the Kings' lead has been cut to just 11 on the basket from AI.
And what a turnaround from the first half. I mean, he's been incredible here in the second half.
Now here's Lee. Shot from 16, and there are the Kings with another bucket.
Could come down the selection. Bad shots in the first half. Here in the second, using his head, finding some more efficient opportunities to score.
Passes it to lights out. And the basket is good, and he's got a chance here for one more at the line.
Taking it up strong against size. He does not lack for confidence.
Yeah, hard to stop it there if you're the big man. That's just too good a shot and great concentration.
Yeah, I like that they haven't lost their aggressiveness here in the second, despite being down.
Now here's Lee. He's covered closely. It's stolen. Here's the break. Had a chance there to cut it to single digits, but it's off target. Kings leading now by 10. To the paint. It's tipped. Down low. Over to the left wing. Lights out. Taps in the tray. Lights out's got 5 points now in the quarter.
Well, he's just stretching them out. The defense has got to do a better job of staying attached to him.
I'm not sure what the defense collectively was thinking there. You got to know where he is at all times.
And they pick up 2, 6 points for Mr. Moves.
Yeah, so reliable. He clearly needs to be more involved in the offense as they try to shrink this lead.
Lee outside. 1:44 left to play here in the fourth. Just 5 to shoot. Get the shot. And the foul called on Chi. That is his first foul of the game. Here's the bodyguard. To the inside. Lights out. And he's fouled pretty hard on that shot, but he's got the chance to pick up the points at the line.
Yeah, easy call.
He drops the first one, and that brings them to within 10. Good on both. And it's the Kings with the ball. On the wing, Lee. Here's the franchise. And the pass to lights out. From the arc. Make it 5 for 10 with him in that bucket.
That's just a lapse right there. No matter what, somebody has to be there and get a hand up in the shooter's face.
and there's no doubt about this one. Playing with a lot of confidence tonight. It's a statement victory for the Kings.
This was a very efficient offense tonight.
And they found a way to get their shots to go down. A little luck didn't hurt. A lot of their 50-50 shots fell their way.
And during the long NBA season, each contest important here tonight. Tonight's win will give them 4 on the season.
And with the win approaching, they'll take the first game here of 2 that they'll play against this team. Nice to get that first one out of the way and set the tone.
And as usual, some extra work tonight in what was a quality big impact game for the franchise.
Well, just a force on the glass, did a fantastic job crashing the boards and coming up with seemingly every rebound.
Misses from the corner. 6 seconds separating the shot and game clocks. Lee outside. 5 on the shot. Picks up 2 points. So 1 free throw coming up.
Making every effort to put this game on ice.
Loved it. The guys are staying aggressive late in this ball game, just not wanting to let go of the rope.
And that one misses. This one just all but in the books.
Yeah, too many points, not enough time.
That one doesn't go. Here's prime time, and the layup falls.
This arena was rocking throughout the night. You could really feel the energy.
A huge motivation, always great for a young team, but veteran players also appreciate that fans come with that kind of energy and get into the spirit of the game.
So the Kings win it. Some good competition, but the hometown advantage and their ability to stay focused, I think, made the difference.
Yeah, and the first step in becoming a good team is your ability to win at home. And they really seem to revel in that